And welcome to the final part of Bioshock Infinite. If you remember from last time, we just dealt with the frat house, and now we're up into his ship here, waiting to do battle and die a lot.
Elizabeth, stop talking just for me.
Any moment now. Now, that's the only time in the entire game I actually use Return to Sender without holding it down. Just deal with shit. I love when I miss, like, right in their face.
I love how after you turn around to Elizabeth, you just get turned around and you get shot anyway.
She shrugged at me. Was
like he was waiting for you.
That actually kind of sucked, but he's gonna turn over and die, whatever. Oh, what the hell?
I got some drop.
Some fries, motherfucker!
You didn't need to toss it, Elizabeth.
Punch.
But.
Go fly off the end. Aw. Everyone's freaking out in there.
We're gonna have a party! We're gonna have...
Andrew WK, is that you? Oh, shit. Is there a party down here?
Just an army of Andrew WKs.
They're just headbanging and falling off the end of the ship.
Why are all of our noses bleeding?
Because we headbutt each other in a small compartment.
Oh, yeah, shit.
I love how my little trap actually worked pretty well because it killed like 9 people.
I didn't even see you lay the trap.
I love how it gives me lockpicks now, like I'm actually going to use them. That's cute.
Well, you can use this lockpick on that vending machine there.
I'm stupid because at this point I'm considering saving my money when I have no other vending machines to go to after this point. I even upgraded my machine gun, a gun I never use.
Well, you're gonna need that money for Elizabeth when she brings you back to life.
True. I have to bribe her to revive me. Come on, I can help this time. You died 10 times.
Syringes are expensive.
But you keep on using the same one. What's your excuse?
You're supposed to get another needle?
I'm not a doctor. Poke.
I love how this time she just said, keep your eyes open. Elizabeth, I'm dead. I can't.
Also, like, the physicality of me lying on my back and she pulls me up from my arm. Like, my body must be just rigid and being pulled up like Frankenstein.
Elizabeth. Well, she must be pretty strong to just pull you up like that every single time.
Get out of the way, Elizabeth. I need a gun. Alright, you guard this engine. It's going nowhere. Good job, Ghost. Hold you, rocket automaton. Again, I'm being stupid. I'm holding down the button. So I'm going to use it. I spilled my lemonade. I'm sorry.
I just love when you hear an explosion and then she says it.
Sorry, I didn't. Sorry.
Is that how bombs work?
When it explodes, you apologize. That way they don't haunt you.
Apologies aren't the answer?
So, cancer's bad, right?
I told you I'm not a doctor, I mean...
I like how through this whole thing there's a bunch of guys just over there. And you don't even bother with them for minutes on end.
They got their own problems, really.
You don't know what they're going through.
Yeah, I know, it might be a little rough. Plus, look, turrets. I'm really worried here. I'm playing right. Shut up. At this point, I'm just ready for this to be over. I've been fighting dudes for the past few hours.
Yeah, this fight does seem to drag quite a bit.
Plus, I know when I get near the end of these end of the game parts, I tend to record them in huge chunks, so this is like 5 or 6 hours in.
Yeah.
Alright, time to kill him. Our shit.
That's glass, Travis.
Well, other glass... Duh, you're not even gonna look at me, son of a bitch.
So disappointed in you.
You didn't. God. I don't want to talk to you.
And Booker sulks down the stairs.
I say back to her, sorry.
She blows something up anyway.
I'm a little busy. Clear the line of those pods. We can use them to gain access to the decks. Booker, cash. God, just let...
Yeah, it's great, I guess.
Guns.
Catched him with his mouth.
Booker, that button didn't say push.
I have seen the
Great, I'm launching just Confederate soldier robots into the middle of these fields in the ocean. New York City.
Children's birthday parties.
Yay, Daddy, it's that clown we ordered!
I didn't order any clown, but this'll do.
Imagine by the time it gets to the ground, it's like half broke, or just like, welcome to the party! For America! Columbia.
And he better not be having fun on the skyline.
I feel like when they have the deep voice echoing thing, that's another guy just trying to talk at the same time. So he's like, look, Richard, let me do it on my own.
Destiny.
Oh, dude, come on.
Elizabeth.
So good for this area is that since it's a multi-tiered battling zone, just a multiple strategies abound. But this one's just to ride the rails. There's no reason not to. Especially when you get just summon a bunch of shit. I don't know why I did that.
Yeah, I died the most during Comstock House, but this one came closely second to it, because I still didn't have any help or ammo.
Storm helped a lot, as you can see. It helped through the entire game. MVP.
Why are you apologizing so much?
Elizabeth, what did you do?
She's apologizing for you, it's not like you're going to.
She's apologizing for what she's going to do. Spoiler.
I think she's just accidentally blowing up multiverses unintentionally.
Why are they dropping so slow? Sorry, I summoned your grandmother to this world. What? Blah!
Grandma, you're alive even though you died.
I'm still dead. Blah.
That's all?
This is one of those classic, you need to set up a bunch of things because people are going to hit you like waves in a survival style thing, but you don't need to kill them all, just live.
That's good advice, Travis, just live.
So far, it hasn't been my strong suit. This God damn.
What's the other half?
I dare you to try to throw a gun from 50 feet away. It's...
And have it curve.
Yep, land. Oh shit.
Good morning.
I feel like Elizabeth walks up and is like, don't shoot, I'm just injecting him.
And they're all like, alright guys, time out.
Go for coffee.
Her little 80 pound frame's trying to drag you back underneath the ship here.
She's dragging your corpse up the stairs, but she accidentally drops, and you just see Booker rolling down.
Mission accomplished!
Something I did notice about Elizabeth, it looks like throughout the game her eye makeup has gotten smudged and there's dark circles under her eyes now, so she just looks exhausted and very done with everything.
I don't even know necessarily that's even makeup. I mean, we just saved her from torture. It could be bruises.
Oh, baby.
It could be makeup, though. Just saying.
I think she just rubbed some dirt in her eyes.
What does dirt feel like? Ah, great!
I look gritty like you now, Booker.
Elizabeth, I've died so many times.
Is this how you got your beard?
Alright, I know fighting's all just fuck it.
Yeah, I don't feel like dying right now.
We weren't done yet.
I am.
Every time you go up here, Comstock is just like, DeWitt, motherfucker, what are you gonna do, motherfucker? But he knows because we're only one level away from kicking his ass here. The third dock is definitely gonna be one of the harder parts, so crows is needed.
You start getting higher and higher. No, wait, there's a ghost! Ooh, it's haunting the second. What do you mean ghost gun's a thing?
I know it's a little late to say this, but are you open to bribes?
Booker, I will give you the other half of my tuna sandwich if you leave.
I hate tuna.
So do I.
We share that in common, you see?
We are brethren.
There's not so much different, you and I.
The only difference between Comstock and Booker is the name and how you spelt. That's not how it went, right?
I fucked up. So... tactic we did last time. Crow him, shoot him. Crow him, shoot him. See, shocking does nothing.
Crow him, shoot him, Elizabeth Wee.
Basically, if you see her kind of flying on rails for no reason. I'll distract him. Hold on. Hold on, guys. Let me inject him.
She's got to entertain herself somehow as you keep dying.
Maybe that's where the money's going. He's bribing the soldiers to kind of turn into deaf ear to what she's doing. Look, I got 10 golden eagles here for you.
Coin for you, coin for you.
I just think it's great that this time she didn't even say anything. She just put you back up.
Yep. That's kind of more of a...
This again.
I just wanted to glare at you.
There he is. Because it took probably, you know, the girl to drag you, like, cross that field probably a good 2 hours.
How did she get the handyman stop?
She is pretty strong, admittedly. The guy's fighting crows down there. Oh, goddammit. Oh. I don't know why I'm using the sniper rifle.
Oh, yeah, the crows can be set on fire, right? Would that help?
Not so much against the handyman. I suppose it could do some extra damage, but that wastes too much salt, to be honest.
That would take some precision, I think.
Thanks. Not so much, because it would probably explode on impact on the big cloud of them. Alright, Rocket Automaton, take care of the rest of them. I feel lazy. Plus, I know I'm gonna have to fight a ton of them later. Oh, I think he died.
Okay, Booker. If you can guess the number behind my back, you can leave.
Or maybe we could just do something like Handsome Jack did, where it's just like, I have an idea. Why don't you kill yourself? Think about it. It's not so bad.
Booker's like, I've already came back 15 times.
Death. That's funny, injections. This is definitely coming off as kind of a last stand area, because there's two little badass rocket turrets here that if you just ran out going like, I'm Victor, you're gonna die.
Comstock sure has a lot of defense.
Not right now, I just shot a bomb.
Here you go! Great!
Not that I'm gonna use it, but whatever.
I like to think that was more of a great.
Chocolate.
He's just getting bored of it. Skyline
to the prophet's cabin. But wait, some value! Oh, this is my last bit of value.
Let's make it count, kids.
Yeah, we'll sure make it count here. Fuck it, we're not gonna do anything. You hold on to this. Yeah, because I need it, yeah. Alright. Final ride up to meet Mr. Comstock. Let's see if he tries to bribe us away from this.
You've come to wipe your slate clean, false shepherd.
Yeah!
But time will walk backwards before you find redemption.
No, it won't. You'll die.
Some sins can't be forgiven.
I already forgot.
Come on, Booker. Let's do rock, paper, scissors.
We can do it from behind the microphone. I'll be honest.
I'll go first. Rock, what did you get?
Scissors, I win.
I'm just assuming.
So look at this thing. That's our home. And remember that big blue thing underneath the tower there? The siphon there was actually suppressing Elizabeth's power and is still suppressing Elizabeth's power. It's the ultimate form of what the game is referring to as her cage, because it keeps her from really leaving Columbia.
Maybe that's why I can't.
What?
When I was little, I used to be able not just to open tears, but I could create new ones to anywhere I wanted to go. But in the tower...
Yes, I'll be right with you.
I like how just casual it is. Yeah, let me get right with you.
Do you guys like chicken salad sandwich?
Booker, no.
I made extra.
Between me and him.
And me too.
A trap. I need... to do this.
I made Sloppy Joes!
Or Sloppy Comstocks.
I don't take a bite, except for out of the sandwich I made you.
That's actually a barbecue.
Do you like the rock I put in the fountain? You, child,
It's hey, all yours. Let me rub it on you. Elizabeth. Crunch, crunch, crunch.
I'm to keep you safe.
Safe from what?
I can't afford a sponge.
This felt part felt very weird because he was just like, yeah, hey. If you remember, Comstock is dying, so there's not much left in him at this point. He's pretty weak and probably at least a couple months from dying.
For he shall be as a wall between her and destiny.
It turns out hamming it up sped up my aging process. Who knew?
I've rained fire on you from above.
And that was just me as the dude.
All I needed was to tell her the truth. Ask him, child. Ask him what happened to your finger. Ask DeWitt.
We already did earlier.
Ask the false shepherd. Tell her.
I told you like my sandwiches, but no, not that finger. The other one.
This is actually an overreaction epitome right now. Was it worth it? Although he did try to kill us for the past 12 hours.
Yeah. And torture his daughter.
Nothing is finished.
Look her.
You lock her up for her whole life.
Look her.
You cut off her finger and you put it on me.
Look her, stop it.
As a reminder, the prompt said intervene, not murder.
That's what kind of threw me off. I'm like, I'm going to stop this. Oh.
You tell me, what did he mean about my finger?
I found the apple.
I just assumed you were born with that. I don't know.
Your nose.
Andrew Big KWK comes in. Party, party! Oh.
It's bleeding.
I'll come back later.
Another reminder that I'm still cool. Talking about.
You too. He's bleeding on the back of his head.
I'm cool. Patches his head on the sink. I'm cool too.
Elizabeth, do you want to have a party?
It's the entire tower, Booker.
Destroying the siphon, that'll be a hell of a party.
I don't know. But I'll think of something.
Booker, every day's a party. Every day's a party when you're bleeding.
I believe today we were a lynch party.
Oh my god.
Alright, so next mission, we gotta find a way of completely destroying a giant angel, and also might as well destroy the ship while we're at it.
Go that way, children.
Don't think, just do.
Elizabeth?
They were pretty. I was afraid when they did that she was gonna be like, "I can handle that." Right after Sync Comstock getting murdered, and I was like,
"Yeah,
immersion." All right, we're going to Paris, guys.
Well, Elizabeth, it's time to become sky pirates.
Not the bees, Nicolas Cage. You haven't met this character, but apparently he is Vox.
Okay, we gotta get ready. They mean to board us. You can go place your daughter on the bird.
It just flips him off. I knew it!
What are you doing?
I'm making some adjustments to our machine here.
Elizabeth, he's already dead.
But you got to kill him. I didn't get to do anything.
You never let me have any. Oh, God.
She figured that out quite randomly.
Yeah.
High five! No! Good God, okay.
I'm so glad to see you,
Big Bird Puppy.
If I do remember, I think the eye changing color is a reference to the Big Daddies.
Yep.
Yeah.
Because when they were docile, they were green, but as soon as you attacked them or the little sister, they went red.
Too bad we don't get to really experiment with that, because we never really get to physically attack the songbird here, but...
We can use him against the Vox fleet.
So, I'm gonna tell you, a lot of people hated this part.
I know I did.
I know I did.
Me too.
Yep. I like it on paper. I like the concept, but it was a pain in the ass.
So, big parts of this, for one, we're now in control of Songbird, so we get to tell him to murder things like that. He has a big recharge time, so it takes him a while to come back to do that, because he's overpowered as shit. But our point of this is to actually protect the ship's engine and keep it from blowing up. That can be tough when you're dying a lot. My biggest recommendation from this point, use the rails to travel across the map very quickly. Luckily, the soldiers are particularly aiming for the engines, so they don't seem to be noticing you quite as much. And take out the Patriots as fast as you can. You don't have to worry about handymen, thank God. Gunships. Get ready. And also destroy the gunships as quickly as possible as well. Which you can't do yourself, so Songbird's gotta do it for you. Which, admittedly, that's kind of badass.
And loud.
And very loud.
I stayed on the rails and just aimed. I used the sniper rifle to specifically aim at the engines because that's the only parts that mattered, and then whenever a larger enemy showed up, I'd jump down and take it out.
The best way to do is kind of work yourself kind of from the back to the front, because if you work it from the front to the back, you're more on off not get shot before you really do any kind of good. Also, the back is full of ammunition, so feel free to take weapons when necessary. Take out the gunship.
You're gonna understand me, right?
Oh, the songbird? He sings a lot.
Because well, he just says, go there, and the bird's just like, well, I guess I'm going there.
Oh, wait.
<Ooh-doo-doo-doo>.
Elizabeth, okay.
God damn it!
There's sometimes I understand it. That was not one of those times.
Impressed?
I'm the coolest.
Getting shot.
Elizabeth, now's not the time to be cool.
Punch yourself in the face. Now I am.
Just a waterfall of blood.
Also, keep in mind about the rockets. You can shoot the rockets out of the air. That's why they're slow. Probably a good idea because the rocket dudes are kind of tough to kill.
So, how long did it take you guys to beat this first playthrough?
I don't remember.
I lost once. That's it.
It took me 4 tries.
Yeah, around 4 or 5 thereabouts for me. Mostly because I had to strategize, and I'm bad at strategy.
This game is basically making up for the fact that there really isn't a boss enemy per se, so just fling a bunch of enemies at us at once.
Yeah, I was a little disappointed in that, actually.
Also watch the awesomeness of this guy taking down a giant zeppelin. Like, yeah. Now, particularly the Patriots are probably the most damaging and damning to your progress here, so aim for them. Luckily, as I mentioned, they tend to aim directly where the motor is, so if you get right behind them, you can kill them pretty quick. This is where it starts getting a little bit tough.
Elizabeth, help!
This is also where Storm helps a lot, too.
Did they always send 2 Patriots at a time?
Generally, yeah. I have to admit, the end of this game is not much fun. At least the gameplay aspect of it.
Yeah.
It's all worth it in the end. This just reminded me of why I didn't like Bioshock 2 very much, because this is also how Bioshock 2 ended.
Really?
Just protecting an area while fighting a bunch of dudes. While also summoning someone to help you every now and then.
Well, I could definitely say that they focused on a different part of the end game instead of the actual gameplay.
Well, to be honest, even the original Bioshock, the big part they mentioned was probably the weakest was the end of the boss fight, basically, that you had.
Mm-hmm.
Which admittedly is true.
I'll agree, but I still prefer that over this.
Well, yeah.
It more seemed like we don't have a main boss, so how can we fill that video game quota?
Kind of like that, but at the same time, at least...
Yeah.
I feel like at the very least this is kind of story relevant, you know?
Yeah, true. The Vox are still here.
Alright, Gun Ghost, you're on guard for here. And actually, I use the machine gun, go figure. Probably not my brightest decision in my life. I should pick up that RPG, but I won't.
When you're full.
Just topping you off, Booker.
How can you be so peppy during all this?
Salts, tears, pros.
Good enough reasoning. Okay, Booker, this actually makes me angry, Booker.
TD looked kind of pissed.
God,
you need to learn how to protect engines better.
Goes after Booker. Do I look like a Zeppelin?
Go after the Zeppelin brings you a Led Zeppelin CD.
What even is this?
What's a CD?
What? Is this a box of music?
How do I put this on the record player?
Zeppelins can't be made out of lead.
You're gonna run out of ammunition pretty easily around here. Just don't get too upset about that. That's just improv. Grab every gun, any use of vigor you can to survive.
Pray Elizabeth sends you ammo.
That's a big one, too.
Yeah.
Usually she's like, you just need more salts when you don't.
Yeah.
Also, just use the flying punch. Despite it, it's still rather murderous. Luckily, the engine is pretty good. All I really gotta do is destroy the rest of the Zeppelins, and I pretty much have this one in the bag.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Are you impressed?
Do I terrify you? Goddammit.
Got hit by another damn rocket. You know what? You know what, Booker? Go ahead.
She's still happy about it.
You know what, Booker? Weep. Do you see that I actually electroshocked the rocket out of the air?
Do the Harlem Shake!
Booker, I swear to God, I am buying a kitty.
I swear to God, Booker, Poopy.
I just wanted to toss it right at his head just so it bumps off of it.
It shatters and it's like, thanks.
Bonk, and it falls off like the side of the ship.
Booker, you're bleeding, that's so cool. And I said RPGs, yes. It makes sense, I mean, fuck you.
God.
It's like, and I'm an idiot because why didn't I do this earlier? Finish off with some punching.
They love getting up in your face.
Well, so do we.
Yep. Because they don't like my attitude. I can really move. Booker's got attitude.
Strangely enough, Elizabeth is the fastest thing alive.
Booker! I think that's pretty much it. But I need more ammo just because. Yeah, I'm done.
I was so happy when I saw that message.
Alright, our final mission. Join Elizabeth up front. Remember, we're going to use our new cage song to destroy the rest of what that angel is. I don't know how she got that far up there that quick.
Booker, you're so slow.
God.
Booker, come here.
What? What is it?
I'm here!
Turn the whole damn thing down. Destroy the siphon.
And that's what you want.
It's the only way.
First time I played through, she was standing right beside me. It's like, join Elizabeth at the front. What? Where?
Everything.
Right, teleport here. All right, give me the whistle.
And the eye.
I'm taking requests. No, those aren't the right notes, Booker. Somber detection.
He just says CAG into the pipe and expects it to play it.
And we're too close, god damn it.
Whoa, I have power now.
Oh no, I have inverted.
Quick, throw the flute at it!
Hits in the face, it explodes. Oh, thank God we're safe. What the?
Where is he? Where is he?
In a loading screen. Hey, buddy.
What are you doing here, bro? I'm underwater.
Now, if you remember from the first time we ran into Songbird, water's a big pressure no-no for the bird. It tends to kind of murder him like this.
Yeah.
So Elizabeth's now another murderer. Just killed a giant monster. And this looks familiar.
Oh my.
You have to admit, the first time you played this game and you saw this part, you're like, oh shit! We in Rapture, baby!
What is this place? Elizabeth?
It's a doorway.
Yeah, and this is perfectly replicating the first part you enter when you play the original Bioshock, so I was freaking out.
Where are you going?
For me, my reaction was, okay, now there's going to be the connection to Rapture. Why? What makes this a Bioshock game? Because you play this game, it pretty much has nothing to do with Bioshock.
The DLC might change your mind.
Until the DLC, but like really, you could have called it Flying Adventure Game and you wouldn't have known that it was Bioshock.
The interesting thing is like, if you notice your surroundings, this must have been within moments of us in the original Bioshock when he went through the pipe and after getting electric plasmid. He probably went through all there, but we just missed it.
Probably gonna regret this.
Also, some reason, we have an escaping bathysphere for some reason. Whatever.
Yeah. A mix of nostalgia and complete utter confusion on my part when I first played this.
I was just gonna vote into it and I'm like, okay, this is the twist.
Ridiculous.
So someone did point out, I think in the main game, or in the original game, when you meet Sandra Cohen, there's a noise in the background that sounds exactly like songbirds screaming.
Interesting, I didn't hear that with that fact, but I wouldn't be surprised. He's just still alive. Oh, I'm still in pain!
I like to just imagine that Booker's having like future shock because of all the futuristic devices.
So now he's in a spaceship. Because their other game they made is called Future Shock.
Beautiful.
Alright, let's go back into the lighthouse we just got out of.
Come on.
Thanks, Bathysphere. Now we've gone nowhere.
Come on.
Plus, Elizabeth is acting very wacky right now. She's just like, follow me. Wow, look at the sky. If the sky ever looked like that, I'd just be like, ugh. You're going to
open? If the moon is ever that big, consult your astronomer.
Damn it. I thought once we were here, I could follow.
Because the tides are going nuts.
Thought...
What is that?
It's a key.
Come from?
It's always been there. I just couldn't see it.
Wait, it was in my pocket. Hold on. Don't try to sound smart. It was in your pocket. Shut up, Booker. And whoop. Oh.
Not stars. They're doors.
Doors to.
To everywhere.
Lighthouses, Elizabeth.
Duh.
What are all these?
So the kind of ironic part of this segment of the game is it's kind of a commentary on the world itself, but it's also a big commentary on the game making process of Irrational, because pretty much all their game series have been very similar in tone. So. This is talking about infinite possibilities, but kind of similar scenarios, constants and variables, which are kind of like all of the games Rational has ever made. Future Shock, Bioshock, Bioshock Infinite. They all kind of had a person in a wacky circumstance having to escape something that they can't escape from. And usually someone going mad.
And what's behind door number two, Elizabeth?
It's us.
Two Elizabeths.
And two of you.
Different oceans, but land on the same shore.
At this point, this is when the title of the game made sense to me. Like, oh, Bioshock Infinite.
Right.
Why?
But at the same time, I also thought the developers were like, haha, we can make a million games. We'll never run out. This franchise will go on forever.
Now we live in a giant tree.
No one tells me where to
go. Are you ready for Booker in space that's also underwater? And the sky at the same time?
Which is basically this game. Because it's infinite. May the bridge build itself now. Left or right, I'll go left.
I love the water effects, though.
Yeah, it's beautiful water effects at this part.
And the way it builds itself.
You can really go any direction you want at this point, because it'll actually just kind of build near to the nearest lighthouse. But as soon as you go through, you'll see what happens next. Because all those other bookers are also doing the same thing you're doing. Which is also a big part of the constants of variable rule.
Wait a minute.
I know.
I know this place. I was here. It must have been 20 years ago.
Beach Boys River.
Wounded knee. I was looking for...
Come on now!
God only knows what I'd be without you. Now, if you remember, we were baptized at the very beginning of the game with a little bit of foreshadowing at this point.
Are you ready to be born again?
And I think it was actually the same preacher, except between then and when he went to Columbia, he went blind, and that's why he doesn't recognize you.
Potentially.
Give me a low five. No, come back.
Oh, where did she go? Oh, there she is. Hi. Alright, let's go get baptized again.
Are you ready to be born again?
I am.
It's hinted that Booker has been to this place before.
Yes.
He looks blind right now.
Is Charles Yamato now online?
No.
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 Jesus, wash this man.
I really need to turn off my network next time I play these games. Stop it.
You shall be reborn as Creamy Crunch.
You think a dunk in the river's gonna change the things I've done? Let's get out of here. Hey, look, these doors of yours—they're all tears, right? We'll open one up. Open one up to Paris.
Now, with each, this is basically putting the pieces together of this puzzle in a irregular order.
Comstock's dead.
No, he was here. This way.
Elizabeth's eyes look much more clearer and much more knowing.
She could see all the doors.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She saw that one, therefore she's special.
But I can see it too.
And behind door number four.
My debts.
Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt.
This
damn Milotosis.
I need to find you.
Really?
Yes. The girl.
Bring
it
everywhere.
Debt.
Still dead.
I don't like people this close to me.
Slowly falling asleep.
I'm very bored.
Well, I guess we're going into this room.
Bring us the girl. Wipe my ass.
Charles Yamato is now offline.
What is this?
Charles Yamato cannot make up his mind. Can you, Mr. DeWitt?
So at this point, we've understand that bring us the girl and wipe away the debt was not talking about Elizabeth, but it was talking about this baby.
Time is running short. Bring us the girl.
Do it.
And wipe away the debt.
Or don't do it, but do it.
I just called you a butt.
If you notice, there's a lot of moments in this game where he mentions where it's like, basically, you have no choice. You're going to do this, so do it. It's actually a pretty big point in this game.
I can see all the doors, and what's behind all the doors. And behind one of them, I see him.
I know every prize before every game show. I know where the car is.
What choice do I have?
There is no car, Booker. It's all a lie.
Mr. Comstock washes you of all your sins.
What? I knew Comstock before this wacky. Let's go get him.
Bring us the girl and wipe away the debt.
There was no baby. The deal was I go to Columbia.
Well,
to
not
get
anymore because you gave
well,
her away.
Now we're going fishing. So shut up and accept it.
This is your world now. Just repeatedly going through lighthouses for all eternity.
See? It's all cool. Your nose just gave it away.
Come on.
Charles Yamato will continue to stay offline for all eternity.
What are we doing here? Comstock's dead. We can just go on with our
lives.
She's
out of the boat.
We can go to Paris, eh?
Chenlin, like Lady Comstock?
And also, by the way, Wei.
Million worlds. It's not over because the prophet is dead.
Elizabeth is king.
It will only be over.
Do one of the doors. You go directly to Hong Kong. That's the twist. So we gotta find a way to kill Comstock before he was born. So we gotta punch some lady right in her uterus.
Hey, the deal's off, you hear me? The deal is off! Give her back!
Give me back my son! I'm my daughter! Are you guys gonna go at some point? Because I'm just gonna sit there. Give me back my baby.
Shut down the machine. No, shut it down. Shut down the machine.
He looks a lot younger there.
Give me back my
baby. Charlie's on his back.
In this dimension, Charles Yamato is back online.
And mind's blown.
Right in his mouth.
You know, I had my guesses at that point. I just didn't think it was going to be that way. But that pinky is actually a pretty big, important moment of that that I'll explain in the credits.
I'm sorry.
For more than just the obvious.
Yes. Elizabeth.
Well, that was a wacky case. Back to where... Oh.
Elizabeth. Chase.
She's gone, Booker. Anna's gone.
That's why I tattooed AD on my hand. Anna DeWitt.
For almost 20 years.
Until one day. Tattoo. Carved into it with a knife.
I thought it stood for after death because he died so many times.
Maybe carved with all the needle stabs. So the person I sold the baby to is now offering me a way to get my baby back.
That blade all of my blood out of my face.
This also brings up an interesting point. When you bring someone through one of these portals to the other side, when you're not like a Latus or someone who lives in this kind of world between worlds, you tend to forget everything and kind of create your own memories from the jumble of stuff in your head. Because memories are basically a segment of time, and if you're part of a world where time doesn't belong to you, then you, I imagine you lose that concept. He's doing a limbo backwards. How low can you go? I was just napping.
You won the competition.
And like I said, we're still fishing.
To your credit, you did try to weasel out of the deal.
This is all Comstock.
Like a human being.
What if I went back? Killed him before he did any of this.
Things get set in motion.
How would one know how far back to go?
That's the only way to do it. Go back to when he was born, and I'll smother the son of a bitch in his crib.
And somehow I won't feel bad about killing a baby.
Well, it's to get my baby back, so...
By getting this baby back, I'll just kill a baby. I said we're going fishing!
Let's go. And by the way, Oliver...
Ollie boy.
Let's kill a baby!
Infanticide! Strangle.
Yeah, I don't like reading.
Are you sure this is what you want?
I have to.
Excuse me? Dad.
Did you say sir first? Oh, we killed a preacher. Okay.
Are you ready to be born again?
Why are we back here?
This isn't the same place, Booker.
Of course it is. I remember.
I am so high right now, Booker.
I'm looking at your throat.
Who are you?
You chose to walk away.
I don't think you're the one who's high, Elizabeth.
You didn't. You took the baptism. You were born again as a different man.
Stop.
It all has to end. To have never started.
So these are all Elizabeths from different versions of the game during its development.
They're more often than not, even in that case, they're actually from different dimensions.
But the one on the far left was in the original trailer for the game.
Yeah,
right.
And the one in the middle was in the concept art.
I'm both.
Well, my thought during this part was how when they kept showing up one by one was we finally gets Booker to say it. Credits roll.
Death piano.
We
And that was another wacky Nickelodeon brought to you by Columbia.
Oh, Yoshi.
And now the game is saving.
All right. So I did put in the ending credits for a couple of reasons, but one of the primary reasons is, what'd you guys think of the ending?
You think Doctor Who's fucked up? Well, check this shit out.
So, if you're watching this, or even people on the call that might have not understood necessarily what was occurring there, which it makes sense if you just play it the first time or maybe not look up stuff about it. The process in which Comstock was created was that baptism. With the theoretical prospect of infinite universes, in some of the universes, he did not baptize himself, like the Booker that we just dealt with there. But in some of them, he did. And that was the division that turned him from Booker to Comstock. What really broke the world in that sense is that all the Comstocks of all these different worlds decided to travel to the worlds where Booker lived and take his child back with them, mainly because he was made infertile by that machine. Through the process of trying to do that, they had a struggle, and Elizabeth's pinky was cut off. What that did is have Elizabeth exist in two different worlds at the same time, her pinky in one and the rest of her in another. That's what gave her the power to open those tears to begin with, is the lack of her pinky. By killing Booker before he got to that point, or theoretically killing every Booker at that point, collectively, that's why they are all collectively, they're all the Elizabeths, they killed Comstock before he was being born. Hence actually killing every Comstock and every Elizabeth except for one. The assumption, because they end up coming at the end of the game, is that all the Elizabeths are dead, because Elizabeth is a product of Comstock, really. Anna is the product of Booker. But you learn in the DLC that there's at least one other Elizabeth left, and also you learn there's possibly another Comstock left, but that's something to worry about later. But the process of that is actually a way to close this cycle of things that have been happening all throughout this game. If you notice, there are points that are hints that things have been repeated multiple times over and over and over again. If you remember one point, at the very beginning of the game when we met the Latusses, they were flipping coins, and it always landed on heads. And there was Mark's heads every single time. That wasn't different people flipping the coin, that was Booker flipping the coin over and over and over again, because he just kept on going in a circle through this time loop constantly because of this awful situation. By this event occurring, the circle becomes broken, hence the song The Circle Be Unbroken. So yeah.
And if I recall, the reason the Lutesses were even involved in the first place was because somehow, I think, Rosalind was communicating with, because they're not actually twins. Robert is her.
Yes.
But in a universe where she was born a man.
Right.
And they were communicating, and she wanted to be able to pull him into her dimension for them to be together. And I think Comstock kind of gave them the money to deal to build their machine. And in exchange for that, they gave him the way to bring Anna to him.
I think it's because they both existed in both worlds that when they destroyed the machine, they basically became Elizabeths, where they had that omnipotent power.
And the only reason that they went back to try and help Booker was because Robert felt so guilty about stealing the child away from him.
And also probably felt a little bitter about being killed by Comstock.
Yeah, true.
So Steve Bloom, Robin Atkin Downs, Yuri Lowenthal, Liam O'Brien, remember seeing him. Who else is in fucking everything?
Sam Riegel. And Okaji Tang. Let's see.
I recognize the name Spike Spencer from stuff.
Yep. He's Shinji! He must have run away! But yeah, this ending was definitely one of the more complicated ones, for sure, because anytime using has powers of time travel and dimension travel, things get a little bit wacky.
Mm-hmm.
Still thought it was an amazing ending. Way to do it, because I didn't expect it. I had my guesses. It was interesting, like, oh, he's both Booker and Comstock somehow. It's a little sad because you kind of grow to like Booker and kind of knowing that he's dead. It's kind of like, aww. Yeah.
I didn't know shiny happy people was in this too.
I did like the ending a lot.
Shiny happy people.
Yeah. I like the ending. I'm a massive whore for time travel and dimension hopping in fiction when it's done well. And that being, I think they did it well and like answered the questions well and tied it all together as best as they could with as complicated as it got. And it was unexpected, which I enjoy, so.
It also left people to question it too. It had people go back and go, what did that really mean? Let me play it again to find out more.
Yeah.
Which is interesting when you look back at things like, for example, the Latus's statue changing from female to male was because of Elizabeth's existence and the existence of things like the Latus's. That's why those terrors started showing up. Because it was kind of messing with the perfect system of these separate times and dimensions. So because of that, things were changing around them. It just got worse and worse the more they traveled through dimensions. If you notice, after we traveled through our, like, second dimension, things started looking a little shitty around us.
Yeah. If you also play through the second time, there's a fuck ton of foreshadowing.
Well, if you also remember from my first gameplay, there was that point where I was actually looking through the binoculars and saw the Latus's juggling. And when I got out of it, they were gone.
Mm-hmm.
Little hints like that, where you look back and at first you're just going, oh, well, okay.
Charles Dorrit's born to crunch.
I love reading these things. To the best old bag in the world.
I just love that one.
Now we're just reading these to see if we can find anything good.
Ian Polipsky, what a nerd.
My shoes hurt. Johnny Fawcett, you're my favorite.
Would you kindly? No, seriously, would you? For dear ponies, Darren Corgi's Doom Oysters and Dean Tate. What?
Love and spoons.
Redacted will never be a problem again.
Here's an old-fashioned version of this song.
Time is an illusion. Lunchtime doubly so.
Glory of the fusion slugs.
Slug lords.
Thanks, hair dye, delivery sushi, my cats.
That was pretty amazing that 2K managed to do so well with Bioshock that they developed their own brand to be able to make this game. And then that was really the only thing they made.
Yeah.
It took him a long time to finish this game, though, to be honest.
Yeah.
Hey, he's got my last name, Aaron Contreras. Look at that.
Oh my god, you might have someone that's related to you.
Well, he owes me a fucking job. I don't got nothing.
You talk to him, get some hookups, you know?
Hey, man, did I find out he's white? And it's like, oh.
Okay. Hello there, white boy. Why don't you help your brother?
Man, Steve is such a gainer.
I read that as angry McCon. I'm angry, McCon! Thanks, NVIDIA.
I thought you were thanking me for a second.
They should be thanking me for doing an entire Let's Play of this game.
You and how many fucking people, Travis?
But guess who did it the best?
Bull Failner, apparently.
Damn it!
He needed one last appearance.
Guess who made Elizabeth awesome? We. You know girls want to marry Corey Spooner.
Who?
She's a lady.
Everybody wants to rule the world. Hey, that guy's close to my last name. And my brother's first name, Wacky.
I don't think we'll ever find anyone with my last name.
Smith.
Downing.
Close, but no.
Drowning?
Downing? This part was cool.
Humans!
Alright, I need you guys to just show off into the microphone for a while.
Can do, buddy.
What? Okay.
So that's clearly Troy Baker, and I don't remember the voice actor for Elizabeth, but that's the voice actor for Elizabeth.
Is Troy Baker the one with the hair?
Yes. Nailed it.
That's what he's playing the guitar with, yes.
I believe her name is Courtney Draper?
Yeah, I think so. Troy Baker actually wrote the song Circle Be Unbroken, and he actually released an album a couple weeks ago where that's the end song of his entire album is this.
Troy, what can't you do? Jesus.
You know what?
I thought that was like an older song. And then it's missing the next line. It kind of sounds like one of those songs that's just been around forever.
It has been around. He just did a cover.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You said he wrote it.
Well, he rewrote it. Troy Baker representing Texas. What? Okay.
I hear Troy Baker is stronger than a group of 100 purple Pikmin.
Probably because he voices all 100 of them.
In completely different voices.
One guy, Troy Baker versus 100 purple Pikmin.
I want that picture now. Is Troy Baker smashing them with a guitar?
That'll be the lead into Pikmin 3. Coming soon.
Is it just me, or do I wish... I wish I had an ear for minor chords and singing, and it frustrates me that I don't. Because Troy does, because he can do anything. Plus, I don't learn how to play the guitar. I have one, and I can see it across the room, and it's mocking me. I tried to learn you, and you fought back. You made my fingers bleed. Fuck you. I'm going to play you one day. I'm sorry.
I have a guitar in my room, too, and I just look at it like, man, it'd be nice if I could take the time to learn, but no.
I can't play guitar, but I broke the strings, so that makes you feel better.
Well, my fingers keep from breaking. When I play you.
I actually had this video on loop for, like, it's like a 5 minute, it goes on for like 5 minutes, and I had this on loop while I was playing Smash Brothers on 3DS and 4 Glory. I was undefeatable.
Well, my victory stood.
Because I was just singing along and, like, being all cool and, like, ah, la, 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 la. Oh, I killed another person. La, 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 la.
Will my streak be unbroken?
It wasn't. Guess who I play, guys? It's Mac.
Another thing I heard about the voice actor for Elizabeth is that before her role as Elizabeth, she was actually thinking about quitting becoming an actor. That she was actually going to go to law school. And then after this, because she did so well and like, garnered so much success, she went back into acting, which I thought was really cool. They caught someone right as they were giving up and gave them something more to aspire for.
Gave them one hell of a game.
No kidding.
Yeah.
Also, there's a behind-the-scenes thing where they kind of showed how they did some of the method acting. It was kind of... It was really uncomfortable, but it was kind of hilarious for me because basically they wanted Elizabeth to cry. So, basically to do it method style, Troy Baker just started yelling at her. And,
Troy?
And he even stopped because he started feeling bad and she went, "Keep going!"
You can do anything, Troy Baker!
Oh my god!
Sometimes you just need that inspiration.
I thought for a second you were gonna say method acting for the torture scenes.
Probably. Kevin Levine looks like a creepy guy, like, hey, yes. Would you like some value?
Whispering in the air.
Would you like some value?
From the circus of value! As he turns on the electrodes.
I hear Troy Baker can fix down broken cars just by playing the guitar.
I hear surgery is kind of expensive, but not so much when Troy Baker's around.
Troy Baker's acting is so good, he's actually the wall right now.
That's a stunt double.
I love his little direction here where he's literally saying, look, you guys are so good, just suck a little bit. Come on.
They could tell like two people just, you know, met and they're just learning a song.
You gotta sound like amateurs.
The only problem I have with this direction is that if you listen to the recorded version, Elizabeth never really gets the beat. And I'm like, you know, if you can sing somewhat well, you have a sense of beat, so eventually get it.
So he gets Eric Clapton, I get Sheryl Crow.
No. You get Billy Joel. Shut up.
Because
you're an alcoholic. Drinking coffee and caffeine is not good for your singing voice. I don't know how she's doing. Anyway, thank God you stuck all the way to the end. Because although you feel bad for all that, here's a feel-good moment.
Ah, yes, cigarettes. Good for you.
Ah, after sex, I suppose.
This will make me feel better.
For now.
Huh, man, I had the craziest dream that I had a job.
Well, remember the idea of infinite universes? Well, if it stands to say that, at least in one of the universes, Booker ends up happy. And let's just assume this is the one that it did. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the primary story of Bioshock Infinite. We'll actually be doing the DLC as well, Barrel at Sea, which will actually explain even more of the story and how this time concept works, so we'll actually be developing quite a bit more with the other couple of hours added to the game.
And oh Jesus.
We already got one reaction as, what?
I do like how they kept the ending scene after the credits ambiguous. Like, you don't know for sure whether or not she's in the crib or not.
I think it's because, I think there's just a better feeling of kind of coming up to your own conclusion with it.
Mm-hmm.
Because I think everyone aspires for Booker to end up happy. So, well, most people, sane people do. So you're like, oh, everything worked out for him and Anna's happy.
Elizabeth's gonna die.
Thank God I don't know any girl named Elizabeth. She's not throwing shit at me all the time and singing songs to me all the time.
You were never supposed to catch any of them. She's yep. throwing them at you.
No more skipping.
And for the rest of his life, for some inexplicable reason, whenever Booker met a girl named Elizabeth, he'd cringe.
No more we, just me. No more we. Until the next video. We!
All right, before we close, let's quickly thank our latest patrons. Oh, shit. Oh, no, listen, the first two are so close, it's kind of infuriating. Their name is our Smoky Horse and Charlie Wood, which is so close to Smoky Wood and Charlie Horse that it pisses me off.
I can see, yeah.
But them, as well as Zachary Eskins and Xenon XI. Thanks to you guys. Now, one of these guys, actually, I'm not going to say who, because that's a little unfair, but is our first patron to pledge enough to get a Travis action figure. So that will be a thing soon, if that payment goes through.
That's amazing!
I'm so happy.
Oh man, I hope, I can't wait to see what this looks like.
We gotta make a commercial when the figure is ready.
Texas man!
Here is Travis!
Travis comes with over 300 different sayings. All in the wrong language.
Comes with a wacky watch, comes with a...
An in-joke that only made sense to three of us.
You'll have to wait till later!
That's in the song, too.
Sorry, we just got off a trip of watching commercials for Wacky Action Bike.
Alabama man.
An Alabama man.
And by the time this video goes up, the pledge money needed for me to buy the new computer should come in. So you should be seeing some new stuff from us very soon. Thanks a lot, everyone.
The future is bright!
Thanks a whole lot.
Thank you.